Okay, we have spent the last couple of videos dealing with this integral, which really is quite a simple one. And not the previous video, but the one preceding that, we were solved this quite readily and quite easily when we made this substitution here, and we obtained this. And then we went ahead and put the differential of this, and we got this expression. So we proved that, yes, we did get the correct answer here. Then in the last video, we again solved this integral using this substitution, but now we have a different expression here. And so let's go ahead and take the differential of this side of the equation here, and check it and see if indeed we get this expression here. So we're going to be taking the differential of the inverse sine of u divided by the square root of a squared plus u squared, or we wrote it here as a squared plus u squared to the minus 1/2. And remember how these work now for the inverse trig functions. The differential of the inverse sine of u is equal to du divided by the square root of 1 minus u squared. Over here, this entire expression, that is our u. So we have to take the differential of this divided by the square root of 1 minus the squared. So let's get it set up and see where it leads us. This will equal, I take the differential of this, u times a squared plus u squared to the minus 1/2 divided by square root of 1 minus this squared. 1 minus this squared, and that will be u squared divided by a squared plus u squared. That's where root sign goes away. And let's see. If we do the algebra here, for the denominator, that's going to be equal to a divided by the square root of a squared plus u squared. And then we still have to deal with this differential here. So let's make some space and tackle that part of the problem now. So let's see. We're going to have this times the differential of this, plus this times the differential of this, and all that is divided by this, of course. So we're going to have a squared plus u squared to the minus 1/2 du plus u times the differential of this expression, and we'll take the minus 1/2 down, so let's put a minus sign in here, and this will become a squared plus u squared minus 1/2 minus 1, that's going to be to the minus 3/2. And then we have to multiply by the differential inside the parentheses, and that will be 2 times u du. And this is going to be divided by this. We're looking at it here. In the numerator, we have a squared plus u squared to various powers. So let's, instead of dividing, let's multiply by the reciprocal of this. And we're going to have then everything will be divided by A, and then this comes to the numerator, and we'll write it as A squared plus U squared to the plus 1/2. So let's see what we have. We have the du terms that we can factor out, and we can multiply q here. These will go away. This is going to be a u squared times this. So, all right, let's see. We have this will equal multiplying here and here. That's going to be a squared plus u squared to the 0, so that's just 1, times du. We'll factor that out in just a second. Minus u squared times a squared plus u squared minus 3/2 plus 1/2, it's minus 2/2 or minus 1, divided by a, and we'll factor out the du. Let's see, we can write this as du over a minus u squared du divided by, this is to the minus 1, so we have a squared plus u squared and times a. We don't want to forget that. Okay, this right here is the differential of this. Now what we want to do is take the differential of this whole term here. That's going to be 0. Then I have the 1 over a. I just took that without the 1 over a, so now I have to multiply this by 1 over a down. So this has to be multiplied by 1 over a here. So let's do that. That will give us a squared and a squared. So this is now this term here, and we took the differential. And let's see, doing the subtraction here, we're going to have 8^4 plus a squared u squared times du minus a squared u squared times du divided by this times this. That will be 8^4 times a squared plus u squared. Let's see, what do we have up here? A squared u squared du minus a squared u squared du. So all we have left on top is 8^4 du. And this is going to be divided by 8^4 times a squared plus u squared. These cancel, and we end up with du divided by a squared plus u squared, and that is what was inside of our integral sign. So we took the differential of this entire side here, and we got this, what was inside the integral, proving that this and this are both correct expressions for this integral. Now, remember though that there is yet one more identity that can apply to this integral for solving it, and that is the hyperbolic tangent squared of x, that is equal to 1 plus the hyperbolic cosecant squared of x. So, if you have time, come back and join us for the next video. We're going to apply this identity for solving this integral, and will it give us one of the two expressions that we already derived, or give us an entirely new expression that we have to prove is correct? Come back and join us, and let's see what happens.